planning phase of a construction project. In this video, I'm going to talk to you about the focus that you as a builder can have when planning a project in this phase. Other videos, which we'll link you to in the description below, will cover the detailed steps, but this video is going to talk to you about your focus. What are you trying to really accomplish? And I know you're going to love it because all of us as builders really want to do a good job in this phase to set up our project well, because we know that projects don't go wrong, they start wrong. Primarily. So if you're into that, you've come to the right place. This is your video. Okay, let me talk to you about this. There's some general things that I'm going to list on the flip chart behind me, and then some other very specific things that we need to do throughout the pre-construction process. So let's say that this is from the start, and we're heading all the way over here to when we have our NTP, our notice to proceed. Absolutely fantastic. Now, throughout here, you have some high level focuses, but I really wanna like dig in with some passion. And this is much different from any other video that I've done. But when you're in here in the concept design and schematic design before design development, right? Not only are you going to win the job, and one of your focuses should be to dig into the project and find three things and start building the project, but once you're in this concept design, schematic design phase, what we really want to do is come up with what's called a macro level tack plan. And the purpose of that is to really make sure that we have your general conditions and your general requirements estimated. Now, here's why. You don't want to underestimate these so that then the designers think they can keep adding and adding and adding, right? Stuff that you really needed money for here for the management of the project, and then surprise them later on. That's your main focus here, is to make sure that you have your GCs and your GRs identified. Late schematic design, you're going to really want to make sure that you're supporting the design team. And so I'll just put design team, right? And that you're focusing on your long lead procurement. I would also say here that you're looking for things like utilities for the plot of land that you're going to build on. You're going to be looking at the soils report to make sure that you don't need any shoring. So any long lead big items, that your big ticket items that you need to really dig into, this is the phase to do it. Design development, you want to bring on the builders, right? And if you're one of those builders, this is the time where you really do your planning, where you really vet everything out. You get your reference class, like they talk about in the book, How Big Things Get Done. You start analyzing your risks, and you really, really make a solid plan. And I would also say you get trade input. If you have early design assist trade partners, this is going to be the phase where you do it. And then when you're over here working in the CD phase, you will want to make sure that you do what's called a fresh eyes meeting. And that fresh eyes meeting will be to tear apart your plan and really make sure that it's accurate so that you can go ahead and submit and get your GMP approved and possibly even include these deliverables into the prime agreement. Now, you've heard me talk about this before, and if you like the other videos, I encourage you to like this video and subscribe to the channel, because we got much more content to come. This is the base of the pre-construction and planning efforts, but I want to dig in one by one on what principles we really need to focus on. First of all, I want to talk to you about visual systems, right? When you start your planning effort, everything has got to be out of your head, right? Your macro level tack plan, your zone maps, your logistics plan, your trailer drawing, right? Your visual graph showing your GCs and GRs, your logistics plan that allows you to even plan the GRs, right? Your support of the design team, real-time scheduling, real-time constructability reviews, right? Real-time budgeting efforts, a really clear procurement log, understanding visually on the site if you have utilities, doing a 3D model to identify if you need shoring here, right? Making sure that the plan, which will include your macro and norm level tack plan, zone maps, logistics plan, trailer drawing, risk and opportunity register, procurement log, and your overall accountability chart, all visual, right? 100%. That's the key for getting it vetted. A visual reference class, visual identification of risks, and being able to show it to the trade partners to where they understand it and see it, and then being able to visually represent the plan in a fresh eyes meeting so you can review it, revise it, and get it 100% ready for when you submit your GMP or get your GMP approved and you sign your prime agreement. This is all absolutely crucial stuff over here. So everything throughout the pre-construction effort really depends on having highly visual systems. So where I want to pause here for just a second, when you're doing this, you're going to want to get styrofoam, foam core, popsicle sticks, wood dowels, glue, all kinds of stuff to literally build this project logistically and tear it apart and be able to visualize it. You're going to want to have beautiful scheduling formats, preferably from the leantact.com website. You're going to want to have beautiful large maps, effective tools for your spreadsheets, for your cost analysis, really nice, well-formatted procurement log, everything visual. Visual, 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 visual. I cannot stress that enough. And the purpose of this visual planning is to do what's called Pixar planning. Did you know that when you finally see a movie, you see a killer Pixar movie or any of the great movies that come out, then that is the 9th time that they've made that movie. They made that movie multiple times before you ever even get to see it. So 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, they literally made that movie that many times. So what they did was they make it, review it, right? Remake it. They show the movie, review it, and remake it. They show the movie, review it, and remake it. And it just continues throughout this process. Now in construction, we barely even do one iteration. Most of the time we get over here to NTP and the project team has to like literally plan as they go. I would be super happy to at least get one major review of the overall project in this fresh eyes meeting before we go out to build it. But you know what would be even better is if we got 2 or 3. I want us to get to 3 times, meaning that by the time we actually go to build the project, we've actually built it on paper or with styrofoam or with foam core or with wooden dowels or with what it, or 3D printed or in 3D on an application, right? 3 different times and torn it apart completely as a part of what they call the Pixar process and how big things get done. So not only one, do you have to have visual systems, but number two, we need to have what's called Pixar planning. So if I'm a builder, I do not want to shoulder the weight of the entire project and all of the risks all by myself. I want to share that with a team and mitigate those risks as a team. And so you always have to do Pixar planning. Another one, number 3, is called experimentation. Not only do we want to have experience with other and I'll go ahead and write that as well. So experience with these types of projects is key, but it's always experience and experimentation. And so what I want to encourage you to do is in this phase right here, going back to the styrofoam and the popsicle sticks and the wooden dowels and the foam core, why not literally build the whole logistics plan out of styrofoam in the office? Why not build the building and the zones out of styrofoam? Why not literally look at the different crane locations? Why not bring in people to review that and double check you? Why not literally experiment with it to see that it will work, whether you're using styrofoam or 3D models or whatever? So just remember, you may have experience, but what about the experimentation? Statistically and historically, the project teams that do experiments with the project beforehand do the best. And the last thing that I want to cover is your risks and your reference class. You may remember this from the book, How Big Things Get Done. I reference that book all the time. It's absolutely fantastic. But here, when you're going through your planning, you're not just dictating a plan. You're not going to shove this plan down the trade partner's throat. You're visually representing what the current plan is so that you can compare it to a reference class, meaning historical projects that have been done before. How much did it cost to build them and how long did it take, right? And you're showing your plan visually throughout this Pixar planning effort to find your risks. And so in this phase as well, not only are you doing the planning and you're doing this experimentation, but you're really trying to find your risks so that any possible risk that you find can be brought up in this fresh eyes meeting and be transferred either to the risk and opportunity register, or it can be abated, so I'll just put fixed, or inside the plan, it can actually be covered with financial or schedule buffer. But that's really what you want to do. So step number one, in pre-con, use visual systems. Step two, make sure that we're doing multiple iterations. Three, that you're doing iterations with experimentation. And that four, you are really making sure that all of that is leading to your ability to sign up for a deal that covers your risks and aligns with a reference class. If you want more information about this, I want you to check out in the description below the book, How Big Things Get Done, and our book, Elevating Pre-Construction Planning. But really, what I want you to do is come at this from a mindset. So we're gonna put this into a Canva graphic that I hope you enjoy and that you're able to use when you're doing this planning. This was not about the detailed steps. This was about the mindset that you have and what you focus on throughout. I hope you've enjoyed this. On we go.